Hello everyone, welcome to all KR Rakam, CBC School Moodle Online Classes. In previous class, we completed first main problem of exercise 8.2. So today we will continue with second problem of exercise 8.2. So here, in second question,
you are given 4 questions again here.
Choose the correct option and justify your choice. So here we have given options. First one, 2 tan 30
divided by 1 plus tan square 30. 1 plus 10 square 30 equals to
2 tan 30 divided by 1 plus 10 square 30 equals to option A
sin 60, option B cos 60, option C tan 60, option D sin 30. So here they are given 4 options. So we have to check what is the value of 2 tan 30 divided by 1 plus tan square 30. So here first I will consider this 2 tan 30 divided by 1 plus tan square 30 equals to, so now we have to consider values of tan 30. 2 tan 30 means we have to consider value of tan 30. So 2 into tan 30 value, what is tan 30? 1 by root 3. 2 tan 30 means 2 into 1 by root 3. Next, 1 plus, here in denominator, 1 plus tan square 30 means, you know that tan 30 value is 1 by root 3, and here the given that tan square 30 means 1 by root 3 whole square. So now we have to simplify to check the answer. So here 2 into 1 by root 3 means 2 into 1, so what we will get? 2 by root 3. So here in denominator, 1 plus 1 by root 3 whole square. 1 plus 1 by root 3 whole square means here 1 by root 3 whole square. What is the value? 1 square means you will get 1, and root 3 square, root 3 into root 3, what you will get? 3. 1 by 3. So now 2 by root 3. And here 1 plus 1 by 3 means what you will get? Here 3 is the LCM, so that 1 into 3, 3, 3 into 1, 3. So 1 3 is a 3, 1 1 is a 1. So 3 plus 1, what you will get? 4. So 4 divided by 3 you will get. Next step, what we can do here? I will write next step here. 2 by root 3. 2 by root 3. And I will take this denominator to upper side. So here it is 4 by 3. When I take this to upper side, what it becomes? We should consider reciprocal of 4 by 3. So 4 by 3 reciprocal is 3 by 4. Okay. So here 2 ones are 2, 2 is a 4. So what we will get here? 3 by here root 3 into 2. Root 3 into 2 means what you will get? 3 by 2 into root 3 we got here. So now to rationalize, we will consider root 3 here numerator and denominator also.
Next step, what I will do, 3 by 2 root 3, I will consider root 3 in numerator and denominator also, root 3 by root 3.
Okay, so now what I will get here, 3 into root 3 means 3 root 3, and here root 2 root 3 into root 3 means what you will get. So root 3 into root 3, root 3 into root 3, 3 only.
So root 3 into root 3, 3, and 2 into 3, 2 is remaining here, root 3 into root 3, 3. So 2 into 3, I can cancel this 3 and this 3. So what I will get?
Remaining value is root 3 by 2.
So this root 3 by 2, which is equal to sin 60 value. Sin 60 value. So the option A is correct here.
See here, they have given 2 tan 30 divided by 1 plus tan square 30, and we have to check which answer is correct here. So here, tan 30 value is 1 by root 3. So we will consider 1 by root 3 in tan 30 place. So when you simplify this, 2 into 1 by root 3 divided by 1 plus 1 by root 3 whole square, you will get answer as here. First, you will get 3 by 2 root 3. After this, you should rationalize by considering root 3 in numerator and denominator. So here, 3 by 2 root 3 into, we consider root 3 in numerator and denominator. So root 3 by root 3. So here, when you multiply 3 into root 3, what will get? 3 root 3. And here, root 3 into root 3 means 3. So 2 into 3. So here, we can cancel 3 and 3. What is remaining? Root 3 by 2, which is equals to sin 60 degrees. So the option A is correct. Okay. So now I will move to the next problem.
So now in second problem of second way, what they have given here? 1 minus tan square 35, 1 minus tan square 35 divided by 1 plus tan square 45 equals to, option A, tan 90, option B, 1, option C, sin 45, option D, zero.
Now we have to check which option is correct. In 1 minus tan square 45 divided by 1 plus tan square 45, which is equals to, so we have to consider tan 45 value. So what is tan 45 value? Here 1 minus tan square 45, tan 45 value is 1. So I will consider 1 here, and here they have given tan square, means here I should consider square divided by 1 plus, here again tan square 45 means 1 square only. Next, 1 minus 1 square means 1 only, divided by 1 plus 1 square means again you will get 1 only. So here 1 minus 1, 0, 1 plus 1, 2. So what we got here? 0 by 2. And we know that 0 by anything equals to 0 only. So here 0 by 2 equals to 0. So here answer is option B, 0. 1 minus tan square 45, 1 plus tan square 45. So here tan square 45 value is 1. So 1 minus 1 square. Why it is square here? We have done tan square 45. So 1 square, we have the 1 plus 1 square, which is equal to 1 minus 1 square means 1 divided by 1 plus 1 square means 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0, 1 plus 1 is 2. So 0 by 2 equals to 0. So the option D is correct answer. So now in third problem, they are given that sine 2a equals to 2 sine a. It is true when a equals to option A 0 degree, option B 30 degree, option C 45 degree, option D 60 degree. So here we are given that sine 2a is equal to 2 sine a is true when value of this a equals to, there are given 4 options here, 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree and 60 degree. So now we have to consider a value as 0 or 30 or 45 or 60 degree, so that it should be here, sine 2a should be equal to 2 sine a. So first we will consider a as, we will start with the option a only, 0 degree. Okay, so here first I will consider this sine 2a equals to 2 sine a. First I will consider left hand side sine 2a when a equals to 0 degree. Sine 2a. So what I am doing here, first I am checking with angle A as 0 degree. So first we will consider angle A value as 0 degree. So if angle A is 0 degree, we have to check whether sine 2a is equals to 2 sine a. So now when angle A is 0 degree, first we will check value of sine 2a left hand side. So here sine 2a, sine 2 into a value is 0 degree, where angle A is 0 degree. So here we will consider angle A as 0 degree. So here 2 into 0, 2 into 0 means 2 into 0, 0, sine 0. So sine 0 degree value is, sine 0 value is 0. So here first we got value of sine 2a as 0. Now we will check value of 2 sine a when angle A is 0 degree. So here 2 sine 0 degree because a value is 0. So now 2 into sine 0 means sine 0 value is 0. So 2 into 0. 2 into 0 means what you will get? 2 into 0 is 0 only. So what you got? Yes, for sine 2a also you got 0. And for 2 sine a also you got 0 only. So what we got to know here? Sine 2a is equal to 2 sine a when angle A is equal to 0 degree. So option A is correct answer. And if you want to check, you can check with angle A as 30 degree and angle A as 45 degree and angle A as 60 degree. But here we got correct answer for 0 degree only, means for option A only. So here I will stop. You can check with other options also. So now I will move to the next problem. So fourth problem of second main. Here they are given tan 30 degree 1 minus tan square 30 degree. So this is similar to first problem of second way. There they are given 2 tan 30 degree divided by 1 plus tan square 30 degree in first problem of second line only, but here they have given 2 tan 30 divided by 1 minus tan square 30 degree. And here options are option A, cos 60, option B, sin 60, option C, tan 60, option D, sin 30. So now we will check value of 2 tan 30 divided by 1 minus tan square 30 degree. So here, what is the value of tan 30? Tan 30 equals to 1 by root 3. Always tan 30 equals to 1 by root 3.
So now 2 into tan 30 value, what is tan 30 value? 1 by root 3 divided by 1 minus, here they have given tan square 30 means 1 by root 3 whole square. So equals to 2 into 1 by root 3 means 2 by root 3, because 2 into 1 2. So 2 by root 3 divided by, here 1 minus 1 by root 3 whole square means 1 square means we will get 1, root 3 square means what you will get? Root 3 square means 3 only. So here we got 1 minus 1 by 3. So now 2 by root 3 in numerator divided by 1 minus 1 by 3 means 3 is LCM. So here if 3 is LCM, 1 into 3, 3, and 3 into 1, 3. So what we get here? 1 into 3, 3, and 1 into 1, 1. So 3 minus 1. 3 minus 1 means what we get? 2. So 2 by 3. In denominator we got 2 by 3. So now we will consider, we will take this denominator to upper side. So what it becomes? 2 by root 3, this is numerator, into, when I take this to upper side, we should consider reciprocal. So 3 by 2. Reciprocal of 2 by 3 is 3 by 2. So now we can cancel this 2 and this 2. So here we will get 3 by root 3. Remaining is 3 by root 3. So now we will rationalize by considering the root 3 in both numerator and denominator side. So here in upper side also we have written root 3, and here in denominator also root 3, into root 3 by root 3. So 3 into root 3 means 3 root 3 divided by root 3 into root 3 means root 3 into root 3, 3. So 3 root 3 divided by 3. So what you will get? You can cancel 3 and 3. Finally you got root 3 here. So we have to check with cos 60 value, tan 60 value, sin 60 value and sin 30 value. So here what is cos 60 value? Cos 60 value is 1 by 2. So this 1 by 2. Cos 60 value is 1 by 2 here, but here we got root 3. So cos 60 is wrong answer. So next, sin 60. What is sin 60 value? Option B, sin 60. root 3 by 2. So again, here we have root 3, so that sin 60 is also wrong. Next, tan 60. What is tan 60 value? Tan 60 is equal to root 3. So here also we got the root 3. So option C, tan 60 is the correct answer. You can see here, tan 30 value is 1 by root 3. So here we will consider in the place of tan 30, we will write 1 by root 3 here. Here they have given 1 minus tan square 30 means 1 minus tan 30 means 1 by root 3. So 1 by root 3 whole square we will write here. So 2 into 1, 2. So 2 by root 3 divided by 1 minus 1 by root 3 whole square means what you will get? 1 by 3. So next, when you simplify, we will get 2 by root 3 here. And into, when you take this 2 by 3 to upper side, you should consider reciprocal. So we will get 3 by 2 here. So here 2 to cancel, so we will get 3 by root 3. So to rationalize, we will consider root 3 in both sides. So root 3 by root 3. When you multiply here, 3 into root 3 divided by root 3 into root 3 means 3. So 3 cancels, remaining is root 3 only. So we have to check this value with cos 60, sin 60, tan 60 and sin 30. So cos 60 value is 1 by 2, but here we have root 3. Next, sin 60 value is root 3 by 2, so, but here we have root 3. Next, tan 60 value is root 3. So these two are same. So option C is correct. So now we move to the next problem, third way. In third problem, they have given that tan A plus B equals to root 3 and tan A minus B equals to 1 by root 3. And they have given that here angle A plus B is greater than 0 degree and this is less than or equals to 90 degree. This angle A plus B is greater than 0 degree and this is less than or equals to 90 degree. And they have given that angle A is greater than B. Angle A is greater than B and we have to find out angle A and angle B. So here first I will write tan A plus B equals to root 3. So tan A plus B is equal to root 3 and we know that tan 60 degree value is root 3. When tan ratio will be root 3, always when tan 60 degree is equal to, sorry, when tan value is 60 degree, answer will be root 3. So here tan A plus B equals to root 3 and we know that tan 60 degree is equal to root 3, means here you can see in 60 degree, here we have A plus B. Means, in the place of A plus B, we can consider 60 degree. So that A plus B is equals to 60 degree. Okay? So I will consider this as 1. Now I will consider this tan A minus B equals to 1 by root 3. Tan A minus B is equal to 1 by root 3 and we know that when tan value is 30 degree, this answer will be, ratio will be 1 by root 3. Tan 30 is equal to 1 by root 3. So that what we got to know here, here in the place of A minus B, we have 30 degree here. So we can write it as A minus B is equal to 30 degree. This is equation 2.
can see here also we have 1 by root 3 only, here also we have 1 by root 3 and ratios are same, tan tan. So A minus B should be equals to 30 degree, like that only. Here we have root 3 and ratios are same, tan tan. So A plus B equals to 60 degree. So now we got equation 1 and 2. So to get angle A, what we will do, adding equation 1 and 2. Now you can see here, first we will add left hand side, left hand part, A plus B, A minus B. So when you add A and A, what you get, A plus A means 2A and B, here we have minus B. So B minus B means we can cancel B and B. So next we will add right hand part, 60 degree plus 30 degree. 60 degree plus 30 degree means 90 degree. So when you add 1 and 2, equation 1 and 2, what we got here, 2A equals to 90 degree. Therefore A value, to get A value, what you can do, 90 divided by 2, you will move this 2 to right hand side, so it becomes 90 divided by 2. Therefore angle A is equal to 90 by 2 means what you will get, 45 degree. Angle A value is 45 degree. Now we will calculate angle B value. Okay, so we will consider this in equation 1. We can write 45 degree plus B equals to 60 degree. This is from equation 1. So now to calculate this angle B, I will move this 45 degree to right hand side, so what it becomes, 60 degree minus, here it is positive, when you move it to right hand side it becomes minus 60 degree minus 45 degree. Therefore angle B value, 60 minus 45 means 15 degree. Okay, so now you can check here, angle A value is 45 degree, angle B value is 15 degree we got. Here you can see they have given that A plus B is greater than 0 degree. So 45 plus 15 is greater than 0 degree and this A plus B is less than or equal to 90 degree. So here you can see 45 plus 15 means you get 60 degree, which is less than 90 degree. And they have given another condition, A is greater than B here. So here you can see 45 is greater than 15. So the final answer is A equals to 45, B equals to 15. So now in fourth question, they have given that state whether the following are true or false, justify your answer. So we have to tell whether given statement is true or false and we have to justify answer. So here in first one, they have given that sine of A plus B equals to sine A plus sine B. So here they have given sine A plus B is equals to sine A plus sine B. We have to check whether these two are equal or not, and we have to mention this is true or false. How to check sine of A plus B equals to sine A plus sine B? We should consider A and B value. So here I will consider, let A value, I will consider A value as 30 degree and B value as 60 degree. For example, we consider A value as 30 and B value as 60. So first we will consider left hand part. So sine of A plus B equals to sine of what we considered, A value is 30 degree plus B value is 60 degree. So sine 30 plus 60 means what we get? 30 plus 60 means sine 90. So what is sine 90 value? Sine 90 equals to 1. So sine of A plus B equals to 1. Now we will check with right hand side, sine A plus sine B.
sin A plus subtraction B. So sin A value, what is A value? Here A value is 30 degree, sin 30 plus sin B means sin 60, because B value is 60 degree, sin 30 degree plus sin 60 degree. So now sin 30 degree value 1 by 2 plus sin 60 degree. What is the value of sin 60? Root 3 by 2. So 2 is the LCM here. 2. Here we will get in numerator, what we will get here? 2 is the LCM means 1 plus root 3. So here in left hand side we got 1, but here in right hand side what we got? 1 plus root 3 by 2. So these two are not equal. Means you can say that sine of A plus B is not equal to sine A plus sine B. These two are not equal, because you can see here we got 1 and here we got 1 plus root 3 by 2. So the given statement is false. This is false.
So now in second problem of fourth point, they were given that the value of sine theta increases as theta increases.
The value of sine theta, increases as theta value increases. They have given that. So now first we will start with sine 30 degree, or you can start with sine 0 also. Sine 0 degree, sine 30 degree, next sine 45 degree, next sine 60, next sine 90. So what we are doing here, we are increasing value of theta. We are increasing 0, 30, 45, 60, 90. So we are increasing theta value to check whether sine theta value increases or not. Because they are given that the value of sine theta, increases as the value of theta increases. So here we will check values of sine 0, sine 30, sine 45, sine 60 and sine 90. So sine, as you know, what is sine 0 value? Sine 0 is 0. Next, sine 30. Sine 30 is equals to 1 by 2, which is equals to, you can say that 0.5. Okay. Next, sine 45 value. Sine 45 means 1 by root 2. So when you convert this 1 by root 2 to decimal number, we will get 0.70. Okay. Next, sine 60. What is sine 60? Root 3 by 2. So root 3 by 2, this is equals to 0.86. Next, sine 90 value. What is sine 90 value? 1. So now you can see, as the theta value increasing, means 0, 30, 45, 60, 90, here sine theta value also increasing. 0, here it is 0. Now for 30 degree we got 0.5. So there is increase of 0.5. Next, for 45 degree, what we got? 0.7. So again sine theta value is increasing. Next, for sine 60, what we got here? 0.86. This is greater than 0.7. And again we will increase theta value. So here it is 90 degree. So for sine 90, what we got? 1. This is greater than 0.8. So the given statement is true, because they have given that the value of sine theta, the value of this sine theta
means these values increases as this theta value increases. So the given statement is true.
So I solved first two problems of fourth main question. Again they have given three more questions or statements. Try to check whether the given statements are true or false. Again, if you get any doubts, you can contact me. So this completes exercise 8.2. So solve all the examples and exercise problems. In next class, I will continue with trigonometric ratios of complementary angles. Thank you all.